This is amazing. My friend Suat, he now has a free add-in for Mac Excel users to bring these items back to Power Query from table or range, from folder, from JSON or XML. Let's take a look. So Suat, welcome back.
Hi, Bill. Thank you for having me back. Yeah, we have good news. We can use this add-in on Mac to create our Power Query queries and easily, instead of using all those stuff that we explained in the previous video.
So this is trick. Great. Their Power Query is called Get Data. Your add-in is called Get More Data. I love that.
Yes. It is more query from table or range. It's just like working on Windows. And then if it is not already a table, it creates table for us and opens the Power Query editor, just like here. All you needed to transform or do something that you like to do, probably adding some custom column here.
Great.
And then
so
do anything else that you would like to do.
We get all the tools of Power Query. What this is doing is building in that connection string that's connecting to the table that you just created.
Yes, just like on Windows.
All right,
yes.
So one of the three is solved, table or range. Let's see the good one, from folder. How do we do that?
It is also easier here. So I just
copy and paste
folder path here and then click OK, showing me this grant file access dialog.
Click select, and then on the next screen, click grant access.
And then you got it. It's here. So just select Excel files and then combine them. Then that's it. Okay.
That even,
of course,
you increase all the transform files just like Windows does.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Okay, load that. Load that. Yes. And show us the one problem that Mac has.
Yes. If I load this, it is going to create my table beautifully. However, you will see this additional worksheets.
And that's because Power Query for Mac doesn't have the concept of connection only. Those are all connection only in Windows, but we don't have that in Mac.
Yes.
So they just show up. But you can delete them from the grid,
yes,
right?
But you can just simply delete this.
When you delete those extra things, it still is refreshable.
Of course. All we need to do is right-click and refresh.
Perfect. All right. That's beautiful. Okay. Now, the next one we're missing is from web. And on Windows,
yes,
they let us put in HTML, and we can choose which tables we want. And that's not possible here in Power Query for Mac. And it's not possible in your add-in. But you do cover two other connectors, and that's
JSON and XML connectors. An API, for example, I'm going to use here. It's the API that returns Mr. Excel books. So it's just creating this little code for us, and then this list that contains the data coming from the API, coming from the website. And I can just expand all this information here, just like before, close and load. It just closes and loads beautifully here. So we can just transform this data however we want.
Beautiful. Now there's a much longer article that we're going to link to, and it covers a lot of reasons why Suat did things one way or the other. A lot of technical details there, but I wanted this to be a quick video because most people are just going to go download moredata.xlam, install it, and wow, their Power Query for Mac is going to have a lot of the things that were missing from the first edition.
Absolutely, yes. I hope this will help many Mac users.
That's perfect. Suat, and you're making this available for free, right?
Yes, this is going to be for free, and it is also open source. You can see the entire code and see how things are working, and you can even improve it, create from PDF version. I would love to see that.
That would be great. Yeah.
It is still missing.
Right. Yeah. Good. Let's hope that someone does that. All right, Suat.
Hopefully.
This is great. The YouTube description has the link to the article where you can download this add-in for free. I want to thank you for spending the last week making this easier for all those Mac folks.
I would like to thank you for encouraging me to do this, because you really pushed me to do this. I mean, thank you.
Yep.
Bill?
That's great.
It was great.
Good. Okay, great. And thanks everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.